Hello everybody, I'm Nick, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can host your Blazor WebAssembly application as a static website in Azure through Azure Storage Account. I already have a video showing you how you can do this in AWS through an S3 bucket, if that's more of your thing. Here we're only going to focus on Azure. I'm going to show this in a more user-friendly approach without actually dealing with a console to do any of those things. You could very much do them, or you could even automate them through ARM templates or Terraform. But for now, I'm just going to focus on a step-by-step walkthrough on how you can do this without messing with that. With all that out of the way, let's go straight into the code. So what I have here is a normal Blazor WebAssembly application that just came out of the oven. There is nothing fancy about it. It's exactly what you'd expect. We have three components: the counter, the fetch data, and the index being the component pages. You can access those. Very simple, very straightforward. What I want to do is deploy that in Azure Storage. So let's start by first publishing the project. And all we need to do is make sure we're in the project folder, and we can do a .NET publish. And this will now build the project and publish the project. We won't dive into optimizing assemblies with tree shaking or compressing. I'm just going to focus on the deployment, hosting, and custom SSL certificate part of things. If you're interested in how you can optimize your Blazor WebAssembly video, I can make one of those later. So with that published, I can go here and you can find your project in bin, debug, or release, depending on how you publish it, publish, and then www root, and these are the files that we wanna push. But where do you push it? Well, we're gonna push it into an Azure Storage account. So let's go to Azure now. Here we go, and the first thing I want to do is create a resource group for this project, just so I can have everything grouped up in a single group, and I can then delete it altogether. And I'm going to select North Europe for this, and I'm going to name it YouTube Nick Blazor RG. That's just the way I like naming things. So we're going to create that. This is now done. We can go to the resource group. And the first thing I want to do is I want to create the storage account. So all I need to say is storage account here and select that. And then I'm going to click create. And the resource group is pre-selected. So what I need to do is give this a name, YouTube Nick Blazor SA storage account name. And North Europe will be the storage. I just want to have everything in the same location. And then make sure you select storage V2. This is very important. The rest isn't really. And then you can select the georedundancy that you want for this. And I'm going to click create and create again. And now my storage account has been or is being created. Now, the base idea of pushing this these files and hosting them is very simple, but when you want to use a custom domain with SSL support, this is probably the main focus of this video. Deploying and just hosting it is very simple. However, there are a couple of caveats that I want to show you just so you don't fall into those pitfalls. So let's go to the resource now, and we can very easily on the left here scroll down until we find the static website option, and we click on that and we click enabled, and then we have the opportunity to provide an index document name. This is where your entry point would be, and for us it's the index.html in the project. It's this fella here. And then you have the error document path, which is the 404 document path. I will leave this blank for now, and we're gonna go back here because you can actually use this in a different way, sort of hack it in a sense, to fix one of the caveats that Blazor WebAssembly has when it's being hosted as a static website. So I'm gonna go ahead and click save on this, and then the saving created an Azure Storage container called DoraSign Web, and I can click on that and I can upload my files. I am not going to do that through this. Instead, I'm going to use Azure Storage Explorer, and I can refresh my storage accounts here, and here I can see the one I just created, And I'm going to use that because I can just drag and drop everything into blob containers and web, and this is where your files will be. So this is where we want to upload our files. I'm going to go ahead and select everything and just drag and drop it in here. And now everything is being uploaded. And as you can see, everything has been transferred, which means that I can now copy that to clipboard, go into a new page, and here we go. The website is running. Perfect. The problem that I was talking about is that if I now try to go directly into this page, the /counter, for example, I get a 404. And that's because the application doesn't know how to go through the normal routing through the index page because it's not being hosted through a .NET instance. It's just a static website, really. And the way we can get around this is by adding the 404 error path document location to be exactly the same as the index. And by doing that, and this can take a minute to update, up to 30 seconds to take effect, it's what we can see here. And what this will do is it will tell the code to keep that, but go to the index.html, and then the redirect logic will kick in. And this, once ready, will be properly rerouted through the component router to the right page. So if we refresh a few times, actually, let's just give it a second or two, and it should reload to the counter page. So here you go directly into the counter page by adding this entry here. So nice thing that I got partially wrong in the AWS video. I mean, the solution I proposed still works, but it's way more complicated than this. So this is probably the one I recommend for this sort of thing. Very nice. So now we have our website deployed in Azure through HTTPS. However, we do not have our own custom domain. You cannot just serve this to a customer. I mean, you can, but who wants to see Windows.net, web core, whatever, to host your static website? So instead, we're going to use our own domain. How you can do this? Well, we will need to introduce CDN functionality. I could use the custom domain section in here, but this doesn't allow me to actually have my own custom SSL certificate and my own custom domain with HTTPS support. So for that reason, we're going to Azure CDN and we're going to create a CDN entry. And CDN stands for Content Delivery Network. And what it really is a mechanism to replicate in many, many servers around the world your documents to provide low latency to your local application users. Usually you do this with images and assets and JS files and all these static files on a website. But for us, we're going to use it for two ways. First, we can have a custom domain with a custom SSL certificate, but also we get the benefit of faster loading times, global distribution of our files, and you get things like DDoS protection in some plans as well. So with that, I'm going to create the Nick Blazor CDN, and that's the profile, and I'm going to name this YouTube Nick Blazor as the endpoint. So this is what it will look like. And the pricing tier, I'm going to go with standard Microsoft. You can click on this to see more details. Standard Microsoft is the cheapest one. And also make sure you select the static website because that's the one your origin host name will be at. And click create. And now this can take a minute or two. Our CDN will be created. So the endpoint has now been created and you can see it here. It's running, meaning I should be able to click on that and go here, paste this, and it should run. Okay, I'm getting a 404. That is because the change hasn't been propagated properly. So we can wait a few more minutes, maybe 2 to 5 minutes, and it should be working. Let's give it a second to start running. And the website is now working fine. So as you can see, we're now behind Azure Edge, which is the CDN. And you can do many things here. I mean, you can click on the optimizations, geo-filtering, you can set caching rules and compression rules. But what we really care about is the custom domain section, and this is where we're going to focus. we want to create a custom domain and also upload our own SSL certificate. So we're going to click on the custom domain and we're going to say what we want our custom domain to be. What I want it to be is azure.chapsas.com. So it's going to be a subdomain on my own website, which is currently my blog actually. But as you can see, we get an error saying that there's no DNS record found for that. This is because in order to verify that we kind of own this, we need to add a CNAME entry in our DNS provider. I'm using GoDaddy for this domain specifically. You might be using something different. This is globally applicable to any provider you have because all of them allow you to set CNAME entries. So I'm going to go to GoDaddy Domain Manager, and in the DNS management page, I am going to add a new entry. And this is going to be a CNAME entry, and the host, which is a subdomain, is Azure in this scenario, and the value should be the endpoint hostname of the CDN, and I'm going to set that here. Now, this can take some time to propagate, but because it's the first entry, we didn't really change a single value to another, it shouldn't take that long for Azure to be able to see this. There's no refresh button, but I found that if you just delete a letter, wait for a second, and then add the letter back, you re-trigger the validation process, and here you go, we have a green tick. We can now add the hostname. So the custom domain is being created, and perfect, you now have your custom domain here. Now, this doesn't mean that you have HTTPS on. By default, you don't actually. So in order to do that, let's click on here. And what I want to do is I want to use my own certificate. I've created mine with Let's Encrypt. It's free and I have it. I don't want to create one in Azure and pay for it. So I'm going to click use my own certificate. It is TLS 1.0. And as you can see, there's no upload button here. The only way we can actually use one is by using Key Vault. And Key Vault is a way you can store secrets, keys or certificates in Azure in a secure way, and services can cross-reference those keys, secrets or certificates internally. Now, as you can see, we have some instructions to do that, and for that you actually need to have downloaded the Azure Parcel module. If I clear my Parcel, first, in a normal scenario, I would need to run the connect AZ account command, which would allow me to authenticate my Parcel instance to be able to run things against my subscription. I have already done this in my Parcel, so I won't do that. But for you, this will just open a window. You just authenticate and that's it. And then all you need to do is run the command that you see here. You would just copy that. You'd go back to Parcel, and you just run this. If I run this, nothing will happen because I already have this principle added. So created, So it will fail for me, but for you, it will absolutely work. And once you have that, then you can go to Key Vault and allow CDN to access your Key Vault. So let's see how we can do that. Let's go back to the, we want to discard this. Let's go back to our resource group here. Yes, discard all that resource group. Here we go. And in here, we're going to say add a key vault. And we're going to go for the first option and click create. And we're going to name this YouTube Nick Blazor Key Vault UN North Europe. And we're going to go with standard. We do not need the premium for this. Days to retain the elite vaults, you don't need to touch any of that. And what you do need to kind of touch is the access policy. You can do this once you create it, but we can also do it here as we're creating this. All you want to do is go to the access policy section and add the access policy. We don't need to select anything here. All you need to do is go to secrets permission and provide the get option, and then select principal, and we're going to find the principal of CDN, which is microsoft.azure.cdn. not CDON, CDN, here we go. And as you can see, the GUID, it's the same as the GUID we used in the console to do this. And we're going to select it and say select, and we are going to add it. And with this added, we basically say that CDN can actually get certificates on this key vault. And we don't need to touch networking at all. We can just create this now. Let's wait for a minute or two until this is deployed. And I will show you where you can find the same access policy section in Key Vault itself as a resource. Here we go, this is created. So let's go to resource. And if your Key Vault has already been created, you can go to the access policy section here and you can do the add access policy thing here as well. And with that, we can now go to certificates and we can import or generate, if you want to pay Azure, our certificate. For me, I'm going to import it. So I'm going to select import here, and the certificate name will be YouTube. Actually, it will be chapsas.com. You're going to have a dot here, and then I'm going to select it to upload it. So I'm going to click on that. And for me, it is the PFX certificate file that I have generated. So select that, and then I need the password for that certificate. So I'm going to put it here and click create. And this will import my certificate, as you can see here, into Azure Key Vault. And with that done, we can go back to the resource group, find the endpoint, go to the custom domains, find the custom domain one. As you can see, this is still throwing a 400 because HTTP support isn't actually supported in that storage account. And as you can see, this will fail because the certificate is not valid. So what we want to do is associate this custom domain with that certificate. Click on use my own certificate, select the key vault that we just created, this one, and select the certificate here, and then the version, which is the latest in our scenario, and then click save. And now this will associate the certificate with this custom domain and allow us to have HTTPS SSL support without that error message, just properly using our own certificate. So this has submitted a request, but you can see that certificate provisioning needs to happen on all the CDN nodes effectively. So it can take up to 2 hours for all of them to actually be updated. But don't worry, for us, it will only be like 2 to 5 minutes. Gives us plenty of time to actually go back to CDN and add a rule in the rule engine. And the rule I want to add is it's possible to go directly to HTTP, but we probably don't want to allow this. We want to have HTTP to HTTPS redirection. You can do this here using a rule. So what we want to do is click add rule, and we're going to say HTTPS to HTTP, and we're going to add a condition, which is going to be a request protocol condition. So if it equals HTTP, then add an action being a redirect and say type, we're gonna go with found and say match protocol HTTPS and leave the rest of them blank, and they will be carried over during the redirect. So I'm gonna click save now to enforce the redirection. Well, this is the wrong name, actually. It's an HTTP to HTTPS, but I won't update it again because it will take some time to propagate again. So I can go back to the HTTP page, and if I click enter, it still hasn't propagated. So that was a bit anticlimactic, but let's give it a second. It can take up to 10 minutes to do this. Hopefully it won't take that long for me. For you, it will only take a cut. And as you can see now, not only the website is running with a verified certificate under my own domain, but we also had the HTTPS redirection. So let's test a couple of things. This is still working directly going to the counter page. And if I go to HTTP and I click, it takes me to HTTPS. So here you go. Here you have it. Blazor running Azure Storage very, very cheaply with our own custom certificate behind CDN. That's all I had for you for today. Thank you very much for watching. Special thanks to my Patreons for making these videos possible. If you want to support me as well, you're going to find the link in the description down below. Leave a like if you like this video, subscribe for more content like this, and ring the bell as well. And I'll see you in the next video. Keep coding.